test the convergence of the geometric series. Now we are considering the geometric series as a plus ar plus ar square, etc. So we have the general term here as ar power n minus 1, etc., which is equal to, we have two possibilities where our r is less than 1 and r is greater than 1. If it is less than 1, it is a into 1 minus r power n by 1 minus r. If r is greater than 1, it is a into r power n minus 1 by r minus 1. Since we come across these possibilities, we have to check that convergence or divergence or oscillatory for all these 5 possibilities so that we can consolidate when it converges, diverges or oscillatory. Now, the first possibility is if r is less than limit of n tending to infinity of Sn is equal to, since r is less than 1, we have the formula as a into 1 minus r power n, a into 1 minus r. So, when I substitute here infinity, here limit of n tending to infinity of rn is equal to 0. So, this becomes 0. And we have a here into 1 minus r, which is some value which we will be getting. So, it is some finite value. So, I can say that the series is convergent to this. If r is greater than 1, limit of n tending to infinity of Sn is equal to, since r is greater than 1, it is a into r power n minus 1 by r minus 1. So, when I consider this as r minus 1, r power n minus 1, where my n tends to infinity, this whole series tends to infinity. So, here the series is divergent. If r is equal to 1, my series will be like this. So, since my r is equal to 1, I will have Sn is equal to a plus a plus a plus a. Here also limit n tends to infinity. So, this is equal to n times a. So, here my n, limit n tends to infinity, my n tends to infinity. So, this is equal to infinity. So, again when this tends to infinity, the series is divergent. So, when my r is equal to minus 1, limit of n tending to infinity of Sn is equal to, I will get the series as a minus a minus a plus etc. So, when I look after this series, when my series has even number of terms, the sum is 0. When I have odd number of terms, the sum is a. So, here you come across two possibilities. The first one is when n is even, and the second possibility is n is odd. So, when n is even, my sum is equal to 0. When n is odd, my sum is equal to a. So, here it does not tend to an unique limit. So, here the series is oscillatory. If r is less than minus 1, then limit of n tending to infinity of Sn is equal to limit of n tending to infinity r. So, now what will happen is limit of n tending to infinity of, I can simplify this as, so, when I look after this series, when I simplify it, when I substitute infinity, I come across two possibilities. That is, my n is even, n is even, I'll have minus infinity. And by my, when my n is odd, I'll have plus infinity. So, here also, it does not tend to an unique limit. So, the series remains oscillatory here. Now, considering all the cases, I say when it converges and when it diverges, and then we will summarize. So, I can conclude that the series is convergent if mod of r less than 1. Then, next possibility is divergent if r is greater than or equal to 1. Then oscillatory if r less than or equal to minus 1.